I'd been for a couple of auditions at the Palladium with Debbie Allen and all the creative team, and Terry Hands, director. And basically, I sort of did a song, and then they wanted me to do a bit of a dance, and then they called me back the next day, and I did the same thing again. I was only 16 at the time, so I tried to make myself look as old as possible because I didn't even know at that point what I was going for. And I thought, I'm never going to get cast as anything because I'm too young. And I went back to the final audition. They got me to sing the Carrie song, which as soon as I heard it, I just fell in love with it, and I thought it was the most amazing music ever. And I got called up to the agency. I was at a theatre school at the time, Italia Conti, and I got called up to the agency, and it was my 17th birthday. And they called me into the office, and I thought, well, it's either going to be good or bad news, one way or the other. And they gave me a card, and it was a birthday card, and I opened it up, and it said, "Happy birthday, Carrie." And that was how I found out I got the job. So we went from there very quickly, whirlwind, to Stratford-upon-Avon, where we rehearsed there and then did the production there with Barbara Cook. It was a very surreal experience for me. I mean, I had never done anything before. I was 17. I was a bit like a sponge. Anything that anybody said, I tried to learn as quickly as possible. To work with the likes of Barbara Cook was phenomenal. Barbara wasn't happy. She wasn't happy on the show, and that's why when we went to New York, Betty Buckley took over and very much made it her own. But Stratford was an interesting time because it broke box office records, and the audiences went crazy for it. There were things wrong with it, but it, you know, fundamentally the reason why it then went to New York was because of its success in Stratford. So that was kind of the start of it, really. To be doing Carrie at 17, just the nature of the piece is difficult. I think in recent productions, they've had people that are older that look younger. And I think that that's a good thing because it's a difficult subject matter. And for me at 17, I was quite naive, very inexperienced. And to sort of take on that kind of role was a big deal. Even though I sort of grabbed it, you know, with all my might, I think that it was difficult. It was difficult. I was given the most wonderful opportunity, and it did put me on the map. But because it was criticised so harshly in New York, not by everyone, I have to say, but by certain critics, it was devastating. You know, I mean, I thought it was great. I didn't know any different. I mean, I look back now and I can see the flaws in it, but I could still also see that there was some amazing material in there, which actually has proven to this day, which is why, in a sense, it's quite cathartic that Carrie doesn't go away and actually has now become a celebrated cult because there was some amazing, amazing stuff in there. But obviously, as a youngster, my first job, it was hard, it was cruel, and it was like a baptism of fire trying to sort of deal with it and deal with the emotions involved in trying to sort of be big enough and brave enough to, you know, cope with something that was a flop, ultimately. People have sort of said, oh, would you ever want to play Margaret? And I have to say, even though I'm nearly 50, I've always felt like a Carrie, irrelevant of age, just because of the deep experience that I had with that part. But it is interesting that when first asked to do this, I sort of questioned, would it be a good thing to do or not? But actually, I didn't question it for too long because I feel as though I've come full circle. I feel I was blessed to be in those initial rehearsal rooms when I first heard When There's No One, sang by Barbara Cook, when they first introduced her to that song, written for her. And I was there, you know, at its birth. And for me, it takes on my own personal memories and achievements. And I feel very proud to be able to, you know, wave the flag for that song and for Carrie and for Betty Buckley, who in New York was just astonishing in the part. You know, I'm a lucky girl to get a chance to do it. This lovely ring here I thought I would put on today, and I never, never wear. I never wear this ring. But when I knew I was doing this filming today, I decided I would put it on because it was given to me on my opening night in Stratford-upon-Avon by Terry Hands, our director. And it's a ring that is, I think, there's engraving on the back, and it's something like 1806. And he gave it to me on my opening night, and he said, whenever you need some courage, wear it. And I thought today was the day.